watching Mr. Fugu Data Science. Today we're doing a Python web scraping for Indeed data. This will be a two-part video. The second part we will use NLP as well as a word cloud from the data that we retrieved today from the job qualifications text. You need quite a few imports, so let's look at these. If you don't have Word Cloud or Beautiful Soup, install those real quick using either a pip or a conda install, depending on your application. Pause the video. All right, let me show you what this data is going to look like when we're done processing everything from today. What we're going to end up with is this. We're going to have our job title, whatever company, location, the summary of the job, the data posting, and a link that's going to need us to go from the original job posting, brief text, click a link, go into the new page that expands these data, and then extract all of our qualification text. Then we will do some formatting of the posting date column. And then we're going to have a nifty little thing we're going to use, which will be taking a list of keywords that we create, like a little corpus, basically. For instance, it could be something that you use for the skills that you actually have or some skills that you're trying to compare against or whatever versus what's actually in the text that you're comparing and see what you pull out of that. That's what we're going to end up with today. Let's get into Indeed right now. So when you hit Indeed, you got a few things going on. You look up here at the top. I'll have to zoom in for you. And what you're going to notice is two things. The first, any of these spaces separated for our data scientist is automatically converted into a plus sign through the web page. So don't worry about this for formatting purposes. You have this right here, which is a little ampersand and a lowercase l and an equal sign for this state right here. And then we got this sort by because I clicked it down here for a new parameter. This little q is basically running our query. So we zoom out. We want to hit one of these job postings real quick, right? And it opens up this right here. We have this abbreviated summary basically right here of what's going on with our text. So we want to inspect this and start figuring out what parameters we're going to snatch, okay? So you click this little piece right here. And then we click that. And this job SERP job card will be relative to every single one of the entries that we're going to start parsing through. That's like basically you could think of like the common denominator, what we're going to look through. Then you could see I hit this H2 class and I get the title. And then I start scrolling down and I say, oh, wait, I got the summary in here. I could start taking the summary. What other information can we take in here? We got to start expanding these out and see what else we could grab. So let's expand this a little bit. We can see we have, what else in here? We have this link. This link right here clicks to the page that we're going to need. So we're going to have to store those. We need this summary right here, which is in the div class summary. So we're going to steal the, we're going to obtain the information that's inside of that. Where's our little, here's our company. That's right here. We open this up. You see a span class company. So we're going to go into there. We see that we need to take our company that's inside of here. So we're going to have to call in this data, this right here. We're going to have to call that in data TN element. And then we're going to have this turn tile link if we wanted to use that. Otherwise, I'm just going to use the A tag. Next thing we need is our state. And that's in our location here. But we have to do some FL statements. I'll show you what's going on with that for those locations to look in two different areas. All right. So after we click that link, we're also going to need all of this and store it. And each one of these bullet points is going to get stored as a separate string. So we have to do some indexing so we can keep the alignment of everything. Let's get started. Here's what we have. You can read it real quick. I'm going to zoom out just a little bit because I got a lot of typing. All right. So I did real quick a range of values that we're going to iterate through. This is for that parameter right here that we were looking at for the string. I'm doing a formatting so you can basically do an input statement for whatever location and job that you have of interest. You could kick these over real quick and indent and make this a function and put whatever parameters you want. I'm not doing that currently. The get request is taking in our starting website. I'm throwing it in as text and using this as LXML formatting, or you can do HTML parser. Just depends on your preference. So far, I'm iterating through my div class job search for each one of the postings on the page, finding the job title, location, posting date, and summary for the job position. We need to now do an if statement for the location. If we find the location, we just take it as text and strip it. Otherwise, we have to look in this new class location and strip that. We will now go into the links that we have for the qualifications page that we're looking for. Now what I'm doing is going into the H2 class for the title and looking for any hrefs, which are your links, finding all of those links, and then converting anything that has this amp with just this and, so we could take it directly as the links and store those. Threw these into a dictionary formatting and then now append it to a list and run it. It is going to take a few seconds. We're good to go. Let's get into our next steps real quick. So we see that we have this length of 229 entries, which means that roughly I think each page has like 15 entries or something like that. And we iterated over 15 pages or something like that for this. So let's get into what's really going on with what we did. Let's check out one of the entries so I could explain. The first entry, we have my job title, which is data scientist, medical diagnostics, and all this other information. And what we want here is this little link right there. This link is going to get thrown onto the nd.com and then chuck this on at the end. And then what that is, let me show you real quick. Let's copy that. Let's just do Indeed, paste it in, and that's what it looks like. And so what we need to do is next, we would take from this and scrape all of this data right here. That's where we would use the inspect and go inside and start working with this right here, job description text. So let's look at that. That's what you need right here. And every little piece of information is in this paragraph, and you just gotta work through and take everything that's inside of it. If you see, as I hit this, it scrolls and makes this blue. That's what we're gonna start digging in next, okay? So let's zoom out just a little bit. And I just created all these variable names are just junk, but just understand the process of what's going on here. So this is the specific column that I need to throw in that I'm iterating through for the length of this so we get all of them. And I decided instead of using LXML, I'm gonna just use the HTML parser and show you could do the same thing. Here's the little class that we were looking for that has all of our information. And you gotta do this try except because you end up getting an error. And so when I did an FL statement, it wasn't working. So the try except worked for me doing the attribute error. And after you do this, you notice that I have this index position that I stored on purpose, because when you have each one of those pages, each bullet point is storing individually. So to keep track of it, you need some kind of indexing. And then the next part that you do, which I've done in multiple videos, is take that data and do a dictionary list so you can map everything correctly. So that's what we do in the next step, is we create our mapping, which would be this dictionary list that comes from the import from collections import dictionary list. And so I have each one of my keys, which is mapped to one of these, and all of the values are put together. But then I'm doing a string join, because what happens is each one of these entries will be a list of lists, and in each one of those lists, you have a bunch of separate strings, and you want to put all of those together. And that's what I'm printing out here, so you can see what one of these actually looks like. And this is what we're going to use later for our natural language processing and doing a word cloud. Okay, now I threw this in a data frame so we could see what's going on. So we have all of the information that we did in the first step up to here. And then this little bit right here is our text that came from each one of these links. Okay, then I want to do some formatting for the posting dates, because if you notice, you have 16 days, 21 days, 30 days, whatever. We need some referencing just because of proof of concept, basically, make it seem more readable to me. I said, all right, from today's date, let's play around with this. I want anything that has a digit inside of it, all right? But when you deal with these digits, what happens is if you have, for instance, the number 30, it gets split into two strings for that list. And remember, this is a list of lists because you have, you know, hundreds of entries. So I needed to convert that into 30. That's why I'm doing this step right here. Then I wanted to subtract from today, whatever the date is, convert it into an integer that we get in this step, append everything else together. If indeed you don't have a date that says 15, 16, 14, 30, it'll say today, just posted, something like that. That's this else statement, and it just chucks in today's date. We throw that into a new column so we could show you that, yes, indeed, it worked. Yes, it says over 30 days. Who cares? We're just going to go 30 days back. Then we get into our trusty old little thing that I generated, and I said, well, let's just say that most of these are my skills right now, all right? And this is generalized, but this could be whatever you want. And I'm making a comparison for each one of these qualification texts. And so I convert everything into lowercase for my little buzzwords, and I iterate through that column that we have, and I convert that to lowercase too, so we could do some matching. And basically, if it's not in our buzz list that's appended in, you know, so like if you found the word and you matched it up, chuck it in, but you're not going to keep repeating, you know. So that's what's going on here. So it appears that this qualification text has these three buzzwords that are relative to my skills. You can have this relative towards your skills or something that you're doing a comparison on with a corpus, whatever your heart's content, okay? Now, I chucked this into a pickle file because after you run a lot of this code, some of this stuff is not fast. It doesn't compute in like 30 seconds. It's like 3, 4, 5 minutes, depending on how many pages, depending on if you're web crawling, you know, this could be very time consuming, as well as we did not use
Selenium in this case
to run through our clicking of buttons simulating. That's another example that could be done in the future. Okay, so here's where we're ending today's video. I'd like to say, please like, share, and subscribe. And if you subscribe, turn on that notification bell. Okay, remember the next video coming up is the word cloud and NLP. As always, don't forget to hit me up on those socials to keep up to date and help me grow a little following. I appreciate everyone who's been watching. See you in the next video. Bye.